Did you know that we share 94% of our DNA with olive baboons? These amazing creatures are very strong and have sharp canine teeth that can be larger than those of lions. They will, however, try to avoid fighting by using intimidating vocalizations. I'm your host, Romi Castagnino, and I'm a conservation scientist, writer, and photographer. Every week, we'll be introducing you to new animals caught on camera traps around the world. Don't forget to subscribe to Mongabay to get alerted every time there's a new video. Olive baboons are also known as Anubis baboons, as they have a dog-like muzzle, which resembles the Egyptian god named Anubis. Olive baboons have a black face and an olive-gray coat that covers their bodies. They don't use their tails to grab things. Instead, they use them for communication and sitting, as their tails have thick padding that serves as a cushion. Their tail bones turn down at a sharp angle, so when they walk, their tails look as if they were broken. The olive baboons are the most extensively distributed of all baboons, living in a variety of habitats throughout Africa. As an omnivorous opportunist and a highly adaptable primate, it changes its diet depending on the region, season, food supply, and even the time of day. Differences in social organization and behavior also depends on its varied feeding strategies. For example, forest-dwelling olive baboons are active climbers. They search for food both on the ground as well as in trees, mainly for fruit. Whereas the baboons living on the grasslands are more terrestrial as they eat more grasses. During dry seasons, they complement their diet with tree resin and locusts. Olive baboons live in large groups called troops, and they follow a complex hierarchy within the group. Males form associations that cooperate in some situations and develop a hierarchy in others. In competition over food, groups with more males prevail. When a male baboon reaches 4 years old, it leaves a group, but a female will stay with the troop it was born into. Male-female alliances can also form. Female hierarchies can escalate into family hierarchies. Sometimes juveniles from high-ranking families can threaten older animals from low-ranking ones. Also, babies from high-ranked females have a better chance of survival within the troop. On the other hand, low-ranked females are often driven off from good feeding and sleeping sites by the high-ranked females, and also receive the least amount of grooming. The main predators of olive baboons are lions, leopards, African wild dogs, hyenas, and crocodiles. Moreover, the main threat to these species is the loss of habitat and climate change. With the rising global temperatures, the baboon's habitat is getting drier every year. Due to this, water sources are being affected. But not all is grim. To end with positive news, the olive baboon and African elephant exhibit a symbiotic relationship in the wild. Baboons use the water holes made by elephants, and in return, the elephants depend on baboons for spotting predators. Next week, we'll be meeting a deer that has a red spot on its chest that sometimes oozes white liquid. Tell us in the comments if you know what animal it is. See you next week.